Well, here's the exciting thing. You know, France has got a citizens' assembly that's legally binding. So it has been happening. And that came out of the Gilets Jaunes movement, working with the environmental movement to form Gilets Citoyens, and realised that what they had in common was democracy. You know, I often say when we're making choices about what should happen to address this crisis, has to pass the lorry driver test. You know, I've got a mate who's a lorry driver. How's his job going to look after this? Because they're some of the most shafted people in the world, actually. Certainly in the UK, the job conditions are awful. I don't want people like that to get fucked over. And actually, what they'll try and do is divide the environmental movement from working class people. And I'm not having it, you know. So that's where I'm from. Governments are in some places doing it. We've got a citizens' assembly running at the minute in the UK. It's not legally binding. It's the wrong date. It's not looking at ecological crisis, but it's a tiny move in that direction. You know, it might have been rearranged in the deck chairs a little bit, but the interesting thing though is the picture a global citizens' assembly, right? I mean, there is no body that gets to say that gets to exist. So we could say it gets to exist. So one of the suggestions is that there has to be a process to define the process. It has to involve people from the global south, the majority world. It's obvious. You can't have a bunch of white people saying, now we do this thing. And there has to be a legitimization process. And one form of that, and lots of forms of it, but would be, what if the citizens of the world would vote for it? Would say, you could just have a simple vote, you know, like let's get 1 billion people to vote. Do you want things to carry on as they are now? COP 26, 29, 500, you know, governments saying they'll do stuff and not. Or shall we have a global, I mean, it doesn't have to be an either or actually. Do you also want a global citizens assembly? And there's some way of legitimizing this thing. And there's also other ways that we could transition into the new world anyway. I think we have to practice it. I think we have to stop thinking it's about other people and realize it's more about us.